Okay, we're gonna do it. We're not quite live, but we're going to fake it and play it. All right, everybody ready? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you and welcome to the Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour. We're hosting a telethon today on the one-year anniversary of our show. Girls, we have the kids sisters working with us. How we got our telethon for the kids? Have you reached any other kids?
Well, I've called up a few people and none of them have really answered.
Are they kids and do they need our help?
Half of them are kids, half of them are adults. The adults seem fine, but some of them need our help.
Everyone needs our help. How about you? Have you got a number for them to call?
Yeah.
What would that number be?
It would be 555.
555, and you can also text, is that right?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, it looks like you both have calls. Wait, why don't you go ahead and I'll let you answer this, and we'll check back with you girls. You hear and someone's calling, why don't you go ahead and see, the kids need the money. They all need the money. We need to get the money from you to the kids. So send the money to us at 555, or you can text us at 555, and we'll have all the money you need for the kids. So let's get out there and help some kids. You got anybody? Can we talk to anybody? No?
Well, I've got a kid that needs our help.
Oh, this is wonderful. This is wonderful. What do they need?
They are very poor, and they don't have any money, and they only get one meal a day, and they're starving. They're not sleeping on a regular bed. They need our help.
They need our help. They're poor. And now I heard you got hold of a rich kid. Can you tell me about that?
It's a little too rich. They got like about somewhere around 200, and they would like to sell some to someone who's really poor.
But they're rich and they still need help too, right?
Yep, they do.
So rich or poor, the kids need our help, and you need to send the money to us, Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour at 555, and we will make sure those kids are taken care of. All right, girls? All right, thank you so much. I know you're very busy. Thank you for taking some time out. And that's right, the Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour Telethon, one-year anniversary. Thank you very much, and thanks to our boom operator. We'll see you in just a few moments. Show starts at 8:30 tonight. All right, everybody ready? Thank you.
to the Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour. This is our 1 year anniversary, and this is our telethon. We're out here trying to help the kids. The song I'm about to play is in dedication to the kids. Here we go. Let's do it, guys.
Thank you. I'm Sid Sebastian. I'm urging you to make that call. Help these kids. Thank you. I want to tell you something. I'm usually a very funny guy. Saver Brothers Coffee. But this is not something to be joking about. The kids need the money. We gotta help the kids. And the way to do that is to raise money for them. And that's what we're doing. Do me a favor, call the number on the screen. Give them a call, make them a pledge, because like I just said, the kids need the money and you can help. Reach way, way, way down deep in that pocket and find something. Cause you don't need all the money you got. And the kids need it. The kids really need it. If the kids didn't need it, we wouldn't be asking for it. We wouldn't. We got better things to do. We're trying to entertain people. But now, here, in conjunction with this telethon, we got a cause, and it's the kids. And you never leave a kid out in the cold. You always help a kid. Any way you can. It's for the kids. Call the number on the screen. Call the number. Make that pledge today.
Hi, this is Bud D.
And I'm Mrs. D.
We're the owners of Fast Lanes Bowling Center.
Come on out and bowl, it's fun.
That's right. You should be out here trying to bowl a 300.
You don't have to be perfect to have fun.
You'll love Fast Lanes. It's not a quiet place.
You can definitely hear a pin drop.
And we have great balls.
I'm not going there, bud.
You haven't for years, Mrs. D. Oh, and we spray our shoes after each use.
Special spray.
So come on down to the area's best bowling center, where the lanes are fast and the bowling's fun.
Yeah, I thought I heard the commander was out there. I'm so glad you can make it back down here. Hell yeah. It is a kids show. We're helping the kids. So heck yeah, it's probably what I should have said. Let me see if we got a little issue there. Oh, how's that? Yeah, is that working better for you? No? Oh yeah, oh, you're on the cut instead of the mix. But more importantly, we have a very special guest. We've worked very hard to get him here. I've been working all year for the anniversary. Ladies and gentlemen, star of Darge Cinema and a musician in his own right, Mr. Steven Glickman. Yeah!
All right.
Yeah.
Should I sit on the couch here, please?
Have a seat. Now,
next time.
Now, Steven, I've known you for a long time. When did I actually first get to know you?
I think that I first got to know you about 20 years ago, maybe a little over 20 years ago.
And 20 years ago, yeah, that's also when I met Jamila and a lot of people. What were we doing?
Okay, wait. So we met because of AmeriCorps, but I wanted to tell you that hopefully you'd appreciate this. Jamila had to come back in the middle of her Peace Corps stint.
Yes.
And we got together and we were hanging out, and she's like, you got to drop me off. And today was coming up Cesar Chavez, just south of Hawthorne. And I was like, this is where I dropped off Jamila, like really, really late. It was like 1 or 2 in the morning. She was like, yeah, I got to go see Jeff. And I was like, you knew that there was something going
on. Well, that was before we had terms for booty call. But it was a very magical moment. I remember I was actually living with Nick at the time. And that was it's straight out of the desert of Niger. What's so funny about that is she had to go back.
Yes.
So it was like this weird whirlwind. And so you hung out with her that week then.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the thing of it was that was so funny is that, I mean, I've known Jamila a little bit longer. She was.
Now, how did you and Jamila meet?
Jamila came in as a mid-season addition to our team in AmeriCorps. And AmeriCorps, which was a national service program. And Jamila came in, and I think that she had just graduated from college, and she came in to maybe like do a pre-Peace Corps type of thing and kind of get all warmed up. And if you know Jamila really well, you know, she was like
preparation.
She is a badass. I mean, she's not, take no prisoners. And before she went in the Peace Corps, we were planning to go to Mount St. Helens, and she had sprained her ankle, and that did not stop her. She got to the top of Mount St. Helens.
Silly, that's nothing.
Yeah, I mean, she was just like, hey, that's just what she would do. And the other thing was before she went off, she got really sick. We had a going away party, and she was deathly ill. But people had a party for her, and she showed up. So the thing is that, you know, she's a real starker. You know, just a real...
What is a starker? Is that a like Yiddish? What does that mean?
It's like a real tough guy. It's like... Okay. Lenny Bruce described a starker as someone who wears a wool suit without underwear.
Well, I might be able to enlighten some of this. Jamila's mom, Sharon, who may be watching tonight. Hi, Sharon, if you are. They're of Scandinavian blood from the Dakotas. And what I found watching this series called Vikings, I think it's a documentary. I'm not sure if it's drama or doc, but I just assume it's a doc about Vikings. And what I found is these people are, you know, I'm of Irish-Scottish heritage. So it's, you know, we live in the shadow of people like this. You know, we were the kind of hiding in the bushes while they overtook the villages and new kingships. Anyway, I just wanted to get to the point here in why we're here, Stephen. You know why we're here?
We're here to help the kids, as far as I know.
That's right. That's right. Astute observation. We're here to help the kids. Now, you can help in several ways. We're helping rich kids, poor kids, kids. Actually, a lot of kids of well-to-do means are getting help from this. I don't know why exactly. Our Trench Digger and some of the organizations that we're loosely affiliated with, it gets crazy. But you can send your check to us, Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour, or you can call or text your donation amount. You can see that here we got some people out there working the phone banks. Oh, they're not working the phone banks. Boy, it's getting late. It's getting late. Better hurry and call 555. Text or call 555. Help the kids, please. They need your help. I mean, look at this lighting. These are kids doing the lighting, and they need help. So anyway, we're back in the studio. We have Stephen Glickman with us.
The moral of the story was that Jamila's really tough. And she will make the effort for the people who are on kind of her list. And what I learned that night was you were on her list. Like, she was off. She had gone in the Peace Corps. And she came back. And guess what? She was going to see Jeff. So that's when I knew things were very serious. And it actually was the beginning of our friendship a lot, because it helped me to get a sense of who you were.
Yeah, well, what's interesting about that is I thought we were great friends before that moment. So, well, I mean, apparently I'm learning something. You were guarded about who was up with this clown.
Before that moment, you kind of were a clown. And then you were, like, not a clown anymore.
I want to discuss my clownship. We used to do a series on cable access called The Harlequin, which actually was about a clown. So things got clowny. But one thing led to another, and eventually Darge Productions created these other movies. One of them was called A Day on the Asteroid. And my great friend Stephen Glickman joined us. We got him fresh, hot, in a single mode. He was looking good. It was like I had these suits. And we brought him in to play Julius Johnson.
It was, I think I was about 30 pounds lighter. And I haven't seen the video. I haven't seen the movie in a long time, but I think I had like a little bit of gray then. And I've gotten like completely gray. And so there's like no more looping, no extra shot. Like if you have to do any, I'd have to dye my hair and go on a severe diet. It'd be like Castaway. Like I would have to be like Tom Hanks in Castaway.
Like a sequel is out of the, well, you know, a sequel could take many years later. But I generally have a rule of thumb of if I'm going to screen it somewhere, I try not to meddle after that. But I still meddle, you know. You know, I can't help it.
I would love if you were going to do another movie in the, like the Lost, it was like the Lost Civilization of Nyanok, right?
Yes.
Like if I had to get into shape for that, for a sequel to that, which I'm not sure I could do that, but if I had that as a goal, that would be pretty
interesting. Well, that's interesting to know. So you would be willing to come back in whether, well, Darge is kind of in a different realm, and Trench Digger handles a lot of Darge's business, but every now and then Darge tries to buckle out. Mr. Clint Sargent, who worked on the Jeff Steele movies, would probably want to say something about that, but I have an idea. I don't know if it'll ever happen. You know, we kind of talked maybe a third in the, you know, when we're in our 50s, and I'm getting there now, 47 today. And Jeff Steele and the people of Neck Hair, how does that grab you? Wow. Would you do Neck Hair for that?
Well, first of all, then I wouldn't have to do the intense training. I wouldn't have to do any of the things where I drank a lot of water and then didn't drink water for 36 hours before filming.
Well, no, you'd be on a healthy diet of beer and throat thickeners, I call them. Maybe some gravy, biscuits and gravy.
I don't even think I need that. I mean, you don't see a lot of heroic movies where the guy who's the hero is just kind of out of shape.
But the thicker you grow it, the less you grow the beard, you know? It's sort of a trade-off. If you got thin face, grow thick beard. If you got thick face, thin beard, you know?
No, well, see, what I'm thinking, if you could wait on this a couple of years, I will be available.
I will be in my 50s, for sure. Maybe even 60s. I might be pushing 60 by the time this happens.
So you're saying, like, you know, thin face, thick beard, thick face, thin beard. But what I'm saying is thick face, thick beard.
Yes.
I could go.
Yes. See, now you're getting it. Exactly. Exactly.
Because
what were the people of Neck Hair? What is that?
Like, you know how Robin Williams looked in the beginning of Jumanji, with the hair and the beard.
Oh, right. Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
A gray version of that.
Okay.
Sure. I could see that. Well, Stephen, we're gonna take a break. It's been great having you. I think we're gonna take a break and then. We're gonna do a song. Would you mind sitting here as we perform this song?
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much for the stories about Jamila, a tremendous woman that will hopefully be saying goodnight tonight. We will. She used to do a few. Yeah, we'll see what happens. She'll hate me for that. And anyway, so let's try this song. This is a new song off our album. It's a new old song. We got the commander joining us. This guy is in, what key is it? Is it in D, Stephen? It's a D that turns to E, isn't it? This is a song called No Lonely Days. And it's, it actually starts with you, Rich, talking about the call-ins, please.
I'm so high.
It's some kind of, but this is our latest album, available on CD Baby at our website, SoundCloud, all over the place. It's called Moon Landing Conspiracy, the musical.
Yeah.
Moon Landing Conspiracy, the musical. And let's see if I can remember how this sucker goes. All right. This goes out to the kids.
do I keep on saying this? Kaleidoscope eyes and rhetorics. I was grooving in some backwoods town. Everyone was trying to put everybody down.
Get up in the afternoon, that's the first thing I want. I need my Safford Brothers coffee in the downtown blend is what I love the most. Safford Brothers downtown blend is the taste of the city. It's great coffee, great cup of coffee. I gotta tell you, the notes are incredible. Stale-ish cigarette smoke. You got the kind of exhaust fumes blending in. Coat your throat so nice, you know. Hey, it's Jimmy Glimmer here. Couldn't make it down to the station, had to phone this one in. But let me tell you something. Please, the kids need money. So make a donation today. Call the number on the screen and make that pledge to help the kids. They need the money. Now, I was the Suit Salesman of the Year from 1972. I'm very proud of that. And I want to let you know what I'm going to be doing. $3 from every suit sold in my store through the end of the month will go to the kids. Also, 3 cents from every purchase made at my 97-cent store. That's right. I'm doing my part. The kids need the money. Please help them. Please help the kids. It's the least you can do. It's going to make a big impact. It's going to help the children. They need it more than ever. They never needed it more. Please help. Call the number on the screen. Help the kids. Thank you. I'm Jimmy Gimler, 72 Suit Salesman of the Year and owner of the 97 Cent Store. Please help.
We're hot. We're back. We're back. Whew. That was fun. Yeah, that was great for you to join us, Commander, Mr. Glickman. Surprise visit. Great having him here. We got the whole crew here. Everyone just here, and I want to reiterate, this is a live telethon. We have people at the phone banks. Can we get a shot of those? No one's out there at the phone banks.
What?
It looks like anybody. Can we get any? We're trying to help some kids here. Oh, I think I saw Steve, maybe. Steve might have got. Is Steve out there? Steve! Steve,
he's talking to your wife.
What's up with the phone banks there? Steve, can you like...
He had a 57 in one hand and a 58 in the other.
There's a lot of... It's very complicated trying to run a show, run a live telethon.
Steve. Not the other Steve.
Let's bring it back to Mr. Sure. Rich Reese. How right. are you, Rich? It's
I'm
been a
great.
Long time.
Jeff, it has been a while. It's been like 28 days.
Is that how long?
That's probably. That all sounds right. about right, right? Maybe 35 days?
Well, I think it's a multiple was last seven. Month, April or
no,
November?
I'm sorry. I just saw you last weekend over there
April.
At the Kenton Street Fair.
Oh, yes. The Kenton Street Fair.
Yeah, the Kenton Street Fair.
Kenton Street Fair. What were you doing there?
Well, I was just walking around thinking about how much less I paid for my house than everyone else there. I just went down to see you because I'd already had enough of that.
I begged you to come down.
The $11 elephant ear was kind of bothering me.
Was that a gourmet thing? Or?
I'm not sure. I didn't get close enough to find out, but I just thought, you know, we don't need... This is Kenton.
That might have been the guys that have the generator running while I was trying to mix acoustic music.
Oh, yeah. Well, I remember...
They were making gourmet elephant ears. Come on.
Who's got time for that kind of stuff? I mean...
I get kind of sick from elephant ears.
Oh, yeah, all that dough in the heat, and it's fried.
And it's, yes, the grease. And yeah. Do you remember, this might harken back to some dangerous territory with Salem and everything, but...
Sure.
The state fair? Do you ever have elephant ears at the state
fair?
Did
you know I got rejected by the company that hires kids to work there because I was dressed too nice for their group interview?
Really?
Yeah, I'm not shooting you. I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding when I mentioned that. Yeah, they said I was supposed to wear jeans. I was wearing khakis, which were known as chinos at the time. Mm-hmm. And it was actually before Salem had a Gap.
Okay, sure.
For what
so we're talking like 85 or something.
91.
Maybe. 91. Okay.
Yeah, 91.
Salem didn't get their Gap till 91.
Didn't get a Gap. Probably
93
or 94.
I wish Portland hadn't gotten their Gap till then. It ruined everything
ridiculous.
Up here.
Yeah.
I mean, no offense to people that work at the Gap. Is the Gap still alive?
I'm not even sure.
Because, I mean,
exist.
You know, retail is great. We, you know, don't believe the hype. It's going somewhere. Okay.
Oh, sure. Especially corporate retail. Yeah, there's a huge future for it.
Right. Like all the jobs from Amazon and Uber is like helping taxi companies figure it out, I guess.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're doing. They're not like destroying institutions or anything.
No. And in
cutting corners on workers' rights or any of that. None of that's going.
Yeah. And it, like Walmart, right? It's like get people the cheap goods.
Because that's what they've. That's what they.
America's
exactly
very
sure.
cheap. I don't. You know, they. It was very. The Constitution did not enshrine our cheapness, but I come from Scottish heritage. I can tell you there were a lot of Scotsmen involved with the Constitution.
You were talking about the Norsemen earlier and the Scotsmen. And if we've got a bunch of those around, I'd just like to say, I'll take care of the tip.
Yeah. Yes.
Especially if it's a place we're going to go again.
Well, no. See, I have an Irish side of me that will take care of the tip, even though it's not my tip. I don't have the money to fund it. But
sure.
I will gladly tip someone else's money. That's the Irish side.
Oh, absolutely.
Hey! Well, that's so Irishist.
Right.
I shouldn't be Irishist.
But I should tell you about these people out in Lake O that I know. Anyways.
Scottishist?
No, they're Irish. They're
former
living Irish. It up. Yeah.
Yeah, recovering Irishist.
They'd be wasps if they could. But anyways, hey, speaking of wasps. I was just down at a Ron Wyden town hall meeting in Florence yesterday.
Right.
Florence, you know, a former timber and fishing town on the Oregon coast, which is now...
Florence, with the dunes.
Well, they got the dunes. They've got this enormous cave that smells, but it's an exceptional value, and you should go there if you're ever down there. I was there to see Senator Wyden, talk to some local folks. And,
how'd that go?
I walk in, and this is Florence, right? This is like, you know, and with a lot of... personal tension after the events up here, but show up in Florence and there's two cops right inside the door for meeting, and then I go inside and there's all these tough looking guys standing around in the back like they didn't want to sit down, and then a bunch of people were sitting, and when he came out a bunch of people booed.
It was like the town hall meeting thing.
I mean, he wasn't meeting nearly as much resistance as, say, that sack of shit Greg Walden over in Central Oregon. But
Greg Walden's like a cousin of mine, I think, or something.
Oh, good. Well, how about some cousin side then? Let's just anyway.
Well, sacks of shit have like a certain fragrance in the summertime. It's like, you know.
Yeah, Walden is really helping the crops come to fruition, I guess.
Yeah, it's fertilizing the dirt. Where once were desert sands, there's now sacks of shit fertilizing it so that new trees.
Yeah, I think the Bhagwan said something like that when they built that dam.
And maybe I'm getting
there.
It mixed up. Walden and Bhagwan, I get mixed up a lot. They kind of looked similar. Like when Bhagwan, he took the hair off and all that.
That's true, but I think Bhagwan had a little more respect for the people of Central Oregon. But that's... That's a whole other story.
Did I ever tell you about the time when I sat, Jamila and I, we went to a cafe in Antelope, and there was an old guy that had one of the breather things that he dragged around with him, you know? And he, like, had this, I assume it was a grandson that was very, kind of, you know, no offense, but kind of dorky, and he was all on the phone, and just very... this other generation that was obviously not this guy, and you could tell he was like make him drag the oxygen tank around,
right?
And he just would check out everyone's business, whoever came in that cafe. Who are you? What are you guys doing here? You know,
right? Well, one can hardly blame them.
Well, and then that's what I found out. He was there in the day, and like his wife had some confrontation at the post office, and they brought all these guys in to move in, and they took over the community of Antelope. And elected their own mayors, and I think, is it still Rajneeshi now, or?
Oh, no, it's back to Antelope.
I thought they, like, solidified a part of the government that's still going today, or...
Well, they changed the name, but then Norma Paulus came in and just destroyed everything for them, which was nice.
So they weren't part of Norma Paulus deal then.
Oh, no,
I thought there was, like, a morphine of the two Eastern India and, like, you know... Goldschmidt Democrats or something like that.
Well, Paulus was
Goldschmidt and Paulus? No.
Against each other in 86.
That's what it is. Yeah.
And Paulus was the last Republican my folks ever voted for.
Well, she was a pervert, man.
No, she was a total pervert. Yeah. But, you know, speaking of kids.
Yeah, the kids.
I'm not laughing about that.
We talk about this for the kids.
And I was thinking about what you were saying about how we're kind of helping the affluent kids as well. It reminded me of, you know, in The Great Gatsby, where Nick Carraway, who is really not as sympathetic of a character, I think, as he makes himself out to be in the narration, but he does say that, you know, if he lived long enough, he was going to start a charity for the children of the rich.
Oh.
Once he saw how poorly, like, Tom and Daisy.
Right.
And Mr. Gatsby, Jay Gatsby himself.
I always think of Sam Wasterston when you...
Oh, sure. Sam Wasterston. Hey, did you see inherent vice.
Yes, with his daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's something else.
Yeah.
Something else.
Yeah.
But it's this weird thing being 47, and I'm like, look at people's daughters. And if I, like, know the person, it's kind of ruined. I see them.
Oh, sure. Sure. No, I understand.
Especially a lot of the men and the fathers. Oh, we have some people watching.
Are people watching?
We're getting comments on the post one of these days.
Well, are they going to call in? Are they going to call in where their mouth is?
Right now, everybody, I want to make a... Hey, right now, it's very serious. Text or call 555, help the kids, help these kids. Do it. Do it for you know, NPR if you have to, okay? You gave to NPR, can't you give to these kids? 555 NPR. Let's go take a look and see what our good friend Sid has to say about this. And here we go.
Hi, I'm Danny Bash. You may know me from my Basher's Towing commercials. I'm here today on behalf of the children to testify that they are, you know, children are our future. They are smart, some of them, cute, others. As you know, my husband was killed. Mr. Bash was killed through no fault of his own in a terrible alcohol-related accident. But we might have had children had he lived. So sometimes I think about that when I'm asked to work on behalf of the children at such a telethon like this. So please call the number on your screen. You might reach me, you might not. And help the children. They are our future.
I'm so blown away by the idea that my innermost thoughts can be broadcast. I gotta tell you, this is the greatest gig ever. Great coffee. Damn good coffee. Saffrey Brothers Downtown Blend is the best. And I can't believe they're paying me to sit here, drink coffee, and talk about Saffrey Brothers Coffee, the Downtown Blend. I'm laughing all the way to the bank.
Back. We're back. I want to thank Sid Sebastian again for, he's with Safford Coffee? Safford Brothers Coffee. We got a new sponsor. I'm not sure what happened with the last, but we're really happy to have him on board. And this next song is, it looks like we have an audio message. Oh, we should try that out a little bit. Okay, this next song goes out, of course, to the kids. This is by INXS.
Don't ask me what you know is true. Don't have to tell you.
it's up to block five.
It just felt like I forgot how to be funny. And once that happened, man, that takes you out of the game a little bit. And, you know, because I don't know what the kids think is funny. And they don't get what I think is funny. And who do you think's coming to these clubs? So I took some time, you know, had to take some time to really think, you know, what's my next move? Where do I go from here? You know, and I'm going to figure that out. You know, because I never didn't not figure things out. You know, I'm a smart guy, and that's what's gotten me to where I am today. And that's where I'm going.
I'm Danny Bash. Welcome to my home. I just want to get serious with you for a second about the children. Please call the number on your screen. It's so important. It's the most important thing right now. Call the number. Do the right thing.
Trying to tell you that we don't have to work with Sid Sebastian. Oh, we're back, and this is another song for the kids. This is a song by a local band called The Quasi. And, it goes something like this: peace and love ain't no game. Peace and love ain't no shame.
Thank you.
Peace and Love by The Quasi. Boy, we're getting close on our thing here. Let's see if maybe we can how the outer camera's doing. Do we still have an outer camera going? Look at that. I'm gonna go take a walk outside and let's see how our count is on the final tally here. David, have you got me out there? Can you see me?
Yeah, I think.
Oh, how about now? Can you see me over here?
Yeah, we see you.
All right, I'm standing right by Rich right now.
That's right.
And we kind of wanted to get a check in on how much money we've raised. Does anyone know how much we've raised yet? We don't have any. There's no final tally yet. But 555, keep it coming in. We're dead at 10. Maybe we can push a little longer. I don't know.
We're dead.
The trench digger said we're over at 10. Might kill us. I don't know. They got all these Russian alliances. I like Russia.
Sure, it's so big. It's fucking
It's great when you're playing like Risk. It's a great place to have. Well, I think this is a good time to take a break, and we'll come back. The Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour, thank you, and let's take a look for the kids.
Hey, this is Captain Ted calling, and I got a message from somebody named Skinny Davis. Wait a minute. Here it is. Oh, Sticky Davis. Anyway, yeah, I'm more than willing and happy to say a few words in support of the kids, and I'm really hoping that people watching this telethon can make a donation, because you know they need the help, and it's something we really got to do for them, and just call the number on the screen. Remember that Captain Ted's has great deals on car insurance, boat insurance. Also, we're rolling out a new dismemberment insurance policy that's, just in case you're getting in an accident. But kids have accidents all the time, and I got to tell you, call the number on the screen, and support these kids, because this is an important thing that the what's the show called, Peasant Revolution Band Variety Hour with Jeff Dodge, that they're doing some terrific work to help the kids. I mean, this is like the most important thing you could possibly do. They need help, they need financial support, and who else but us adults in this world. We can do what we need to do to help them.
A lot of times, I'm telling people that you're nobody unless you're living downtown. That is where the action is. Late night, early morning, however you want your action. And you can be enjoying it all with a Safford Brothers Downtown Blend cup of coffee. Otherwise, you're not with it. Even if you're just sleeping in the gutter and you got your Safford Brothers cup and you're hoping somebody's gonna put a nickel in it. Coffee makes it all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bun warmers, yeah!
Sunless tanning, and all your dreams will come true. Cloudy days need some.
Bunwormers. I don't know. Where are you guys from? Portland or?
Alexandria, Virginia.
By way of Alexandria, Virginia.
Virginia. Wow, man. That's some deep stuff. You guys got one more in you, you think?
We got one more if you got time.
All right. I think we trench digger, everybody. We got time. Okay. It looks like we got time. We're still taking those calls. 555. That's 555. Text or call. 555. Help the kids. Send the money to us and then we'll help the kids. All right. Here we go.
Bunwormers, yeah, take it away. Don't leave your baby in the road. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Bunwormers. Bunwormers, everybody. Let's take a quick break, and then we're going to wrap things up for the telethon. Should do that part when the mayor is talking to you, you know. It's what? Oh, we're back. Yeah, thank you. You guys, I gotta say, it's been a very special night. Do we have a final number, final tally, what we raised tonight? No. Margaret, anything back there in the front office? We owe -1446. -1446. So it appears I'm actually negative on this whole experiment. Well, I don't. Can you put children to that kind of work? I don't. I might have to hire these kids.
Under the table,
right.
So keep it cash. Keep it cash. Okay. Well, look, I'm kind of. This telethon thing's sort of pissing me off because it's like I'm trying to help kids of all types, and now I'm on the hole for $1,400.
Oh, $1,400.
Yeah, man, that's just...
Man, I've got an appointment. I can't...
Okay. You know what? Let's... 555, please, at least donate $1,400. Anybody out there that can, like, pull it together, you know? All right, here we go. 555, text or call. We're going to end this night. Before I end this night, I want to take this moment to thank the leadership of our city. Actually, our state, we're very gifted to live in a state of Oregon. We have this great governor, Kate Brown, Ted Wheeler. And I want to get on to this former mayor we had, Charlie Hales. Now, Charlie,
don't forget the Secretary
I think he's
of State.
Moving, I think he's moving to Vancouver. Is that what you heard, Richard?
I think he's moving to the Couve. He seems like a Couve kind of guy.
Jamila, are you saying something?
Say goodnight, Jeff.
What?
Say goodnight, Jeff.
Say, oh. All right. Good night, Jeff.
Take your job. Stay in control.
Show. Thank you so much. Peasant Revolution Band, Variety Hour, 1 year anniversary. Tells on! We broke even! Woo! Yeah!